Hello dear children, welcome back to our class. Today we are going to study the new chapter, George Seeker Key to the Universe. Do you know what is a star formation? We have a lot of star formation called star constellation. Some look like a dipper and some like a hunter. So we can study a story in which the main characters are George, he is an 8 years old boy, Eric, who was a scientist, and his daughter Annie, and Cosmos, which was a computer similar to spaceship computer. So let's start the chapters, George Seeker Key to the Universe. The story was written by Lucy Hawkins. She is best known as a children's novelist and science educator. One day, George was looking for his pet and accidentally entered into a house which he thinks is an abandoned house. As it is chumsy and messed up, but despite its shabby state, George finds many interesting things laying here and there. One thing catches his attention the most, that is the special commuter, which is small and glossy. The word glossy means shiny and smooth. The computer looked powerful and neat, the sort of a computer we find on a spaceship. George was looking at the working of the computer, which was being operated by Eric. Eric hits some keys on the computer, which a humming noise, the bright light flashes across the screen. He became happy. Suddenly, a strange mechanical voice he heard. "You have forgotten something." George became frightened, and he jumped out of his skin. The word jumped out of his skin means fear. So, children, the computer with whom our Eric, the scientist, is dealing with is an advanced version of robotic human intellect computer. It can communicate through speech. So our computer informs Eric that he has forgotten to introduce him to George, for which Eric says sorry. Then he introduces that the computer's name is Cosmos. So he asks George to say hello to Cosmos, otherwise he will be upset. So now the computer is directly speaking with George. He says, "I am the most powerful computer till date, none was there is in past nor in present." A very funny conversation is being held between Cosmos and Eric. Eric says that Cosmos is touchy. Touchy means sensitive. To which Cosmos replies that he is intelligent than Eric. A debate is formed between Cosmos and Eric. Eric asks Cosmos, "Who says that you are intelligent?" And Cosmos answers, "He can compute billions of numbers in a nanosecond, and also he can compute the life of planets, of comets, of stars, and of galaxies." Now Eric wants to show George how Cosmos works, but he says no. Before that, he wants to George take the oath. Eric replies, "A good point, clever Cosmo," and he turns to George and ask, "He will not use the knowledge for evil. He shall use it always for good." George stand up and start to say the scientific oath. "I swear to use scientific knowledge for the good of humanity. I promise never to harm any person in my search of enlightenment. I shall be courageous and careful in my quest for greater knowledge about the mysteries that surround us. I shall not use scientific knowledge for my own personal gain or give it to those who seek to destroy the wonderful planet on which we live. If I break this oath, may the beauty and wonder of the universe forever remain hidden from me. After he completed the oath, Eric claps his hand and Annie bursts an empty crisp packet. And Eric turns to George and says, Cosmos will show you how a star is born. We will continue the story in the next video. Thank you.